A vehicle today is a transportation device. A vehicle tomorrow is going to be a robot on wheels. What we're showcasing today is a combination of TI's advanced auto processor combined with a software partner named Xperi FotoNation to do driver monitoring, advanced driver monitoring, without a big ARM core. And what this provides with optimized code on DSP and what we call Eve, which is a vector processor in TDA3, is a complete DMS solution in sub 2-watt power envelope. And what we're showcasing here is the DMS solution with precise eye gaze, head, pose, accurate gaze detection, together with a mirror replacement solution that will actually adjust the camera position depending on where you're looking. So it gives a more naturalistic view. So when you look into a mirror today, you adjust your head so as to see different areas in the field of view. When you move to a mirror replacement system based on camera, the camera's fixed and it's unnatural. So what we're doing is taking DMS algorithms to look or to combine where you're looking and then move the camera, if you will, or the perspective to give you a more natural feel. So TI is working on that technology together with Xperi FotoNation. We also have implemented with our millimeter wave radar product line and technology, the ability to do biometrics and to do heart rate detection. And what this does, it provides a complete in-cabin monitoring experience that's not only the drowsy driver detection and things like that, but the health and the other biometrics you would see. So this is a starting point for where we see L1, L2, and going forward into L3 automated driving going. You're going to need the entire in-cabin monitoring system, and it's a great foundation with Xperi software and TI TDA hardware. We would invite you to read a little bit more about that at www.ti.com/TDA. So TI and FotoNation, Xperi, partnered together because of the background and experience that FotoNation has using TI's underlying hardware. Most DMS providers today write software that's fairly generic and runs on an ARM core. And that's fine. The challenge you run into with that is you want to increase the feature set, you run out of performance headroom, or you increase your power. So unless you take advantage of specialized cores, like a C6 DSP or an Eve, you can never achieve the performance in a power envelope that you need. Xperi FotoNation's uniquely positioned to do that because of their experience on our hardware. The performance aspects or KPIs driving DMS quality or accuracy of gaze detection, eye tracking, as well as the latency, right, that you need to run the frame rate of the camera, all of that drives power and performance up. And it comes back again to optimization on the DSP and the Eve cores that FotoNation Xperi were able to do so that they could reduce to almost zero latency. They could run at full frame rate, 30 frames per second or more, without exceeding that 2-watt power envelope. So where TI and I believe FotoNation will stop short is to prescribe what the application level solution should be. So we provide the underlying technology building blocks and allow a modular building block system so that tier ones can take that and put that together in whatever way can help them and their customers differentiate. We're not trying to prescribe what that is. Driver monitoring will at one point be mandated by legislation. It will be a requirement in vehicles. So that does two things. One, you need to figure out how to make a low-cost solution that has good enough features. And two, you need to figure out how to stay ahead of that and differentiate for some of the more mid to premium brands. And where driver monitoring is going, it's going to move beyond basic eye gaze, head pose, things like this, to emotions. So a vehicle today is a transportation device. A vehicle tomorrow is going to be a robot on wheels. A robot in which you can sit, you can be entertained, you can be transported, you can do conference calls, video calls. So it's a mobile desk, it's a mobile everything, okay? It's a mobile device on wheels. And so within that, if that mobile environment can understand and have natural interaction with you in terms of light color, light level, biometric sensing of your face. So today DMS cameras use IR sensors only. So that means an infrared flood, and that's all they use. So you don't see a natural view of the world. Going forward, we believe it will be added, the RGB will be added to that, And part of the reason for that is to be able to do a more accurate motion detection, as well as some other features that OEMs want to do. And then last but not least, how do you make sure you're not, A, leaving any child in the car? So DMS goes beyond just the driver and you start looking at all the occupants in the car, right? How do you make airbag deployment smarter? If you know exactly the position of a body in the vehicle, you'll know more accurately when and where to deploy airbags. And then, you know, there's other things with autonomous vehicles that if you're not facing forward, it gets crazy. It is not a binary statement. So automated driving isn't you do everything or the car does everything. There's many steps in between, okay? So this is why we have the SAE levels of automation, 1, 2, 2+, 3, et cetera, et cetera. Personally, I believe it's not a question of if or but when full L4 happens, L5. What we as technology providers need to do between now and then is provide robust, cost-effective, power-effective solutions that will help make individual automation steps simpler and safer. You're going to have a car then that has blind spot detection, it's going to have automatic emergency braking, lane keep assist, all of these things will be basic features because the cost will have come down. And what we do is when we start helping vehicles be safer, it doesn't matter that the car can't necessarily drive itself all the time. You've achieved a goal of fundamentally making the driving experience safer and more enjoyable.